my Mason brothers from the Kagitingan Lodge 286, represented by or headed by Mr. Rufino G. Arias Jr. Please stand up to be recognized. Officials from Malacanang present, we have here Secretary Arthur Tabaquero, the Presidential Advisor on Military Affairs. Secretary Salvador Espanelo Jr., the Chief Presidential Legal Counsel. Special Assistant to the President, Christopher Lawrence Tigo. Secretary Hermogenes C. Esperon Jr., the National Security Advisor. USEC Gloria Humamil Mercado, the Cabinet Secretary. Former Secretary of National Defense, Secretary Orlando Mercado. The former Chiefs of Staff of the AFP present, we have here General Lisandro Abadia, General Benjamin Defensor Jr., General Dionisio Santiago, General Generoso Senga, General Alexander Yano, General Victor S. Brado, USEC Emmanuel T. Bautista, the Executive Director of the Cabinet Cluster on Security, Peace and Justice, General Gregorio Katapang Jr., General Hernando DCA Ribery and his wife, Agnes, Ma'am Agnes, General Ricardo Visaya, Lieutenant General Glorioso Miranda, officials from the Department of National Defense, General Tan Sri Dato Zulkifli of Chief of Army Defense Malaysia and other Malaysian officials. We have here also Police Director General Roland M. De La Rosa, Lieutenant General Salvador Mison Jr., the Vice Chief of Staff. May also recognize the Executive Secretary, Secretary Salvador Meljaldeser, the Deputy Chief of Staff of the AFP, Vice Admiral Narciso Vingson, Major Service Commanders present, Vice Admiral Ronald Joseph Mercado, the Flag Officer in Command of the Philippine Navy, Lieutenant General Rolando Joselito Bautista of the Philippine Army, Lieutenant General Galileo Quintanar of the Air Force, Unified Commanders present, former Major Service Commanders present, we have here Lieutenant General Romeo Tolentino, Vice Admiral Ferdinand Goles, Vice Admiral Cesar Tacad, Lieutenant General Jaime de los Santos, our Chief Chaplain, Brigadier General Tirso Dulina, members of the Joint Personnel and Special Staff and Commanders and Chiefs of AAP-wide support and separate units and their ladies, members of PMA Matikas Class of 1983 and their ladies, members of PMA Maharlika Class of 1984 and their ladies, please stand up to be recognized. Other generals, flag officers and their ladies, other senior officers present, our enlisted personnel corps led by our AAP Command Sergeant Major, First Chief Master Sergeant Handugan, the civilian employees of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, Colonel Ernest Lee, Chief Jusmag, members of the Foreign Armed Forces attachés and their ladies, our friends from the AAP Multisectoral Governance Council, AAP Financial Institutions, Hero Foundation and Association of Generals and Flag Officers, other government officials present, AAP Officers Ladies Club members, Team AFP, our friends from the media, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. A soldier's life is defined largely by the service he renders, his fidelity to the flag, and his unwavering dedication to securing the peace. All this I adhere to. All this I pledge as I take on the challenge of leading the Armed Forces of the Philippines as the 49th Chief of Staff. President Duterte, sir, my gratitude knows no bounds, and I believe that the best way for me to show to you and to our countrymen my gratitude is to serve our country with selfless dedication and to lead the AFP with purpose. This is my pledge. This is my covenant. The priorities in the area of peace and security are clear. Finish the remaining terrorist groups, neutralize the communist insurgency threat, and support law enforcement agencies in efforts against lawless armed groups. Our commander-in-chief gave these marching orders to those who came before me. And like those before me, I intend to use the might of the AFP to make this a reality. The perseverance, sacrifices, and hard works of our troops have brought solid results in winning the peace and in bringing us closer to the people. Men and women of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, our labor continues as we build on these victories. Together, let us do better, work harder, fight smarter, and serve our countrymen even more. For us to be able to do so, we need to continue our reforms to attain operational and organizational excellence. Operationally, we will continue to improve our capability to address current and future security challenges. We will revisit our warfighting doctrines to consider new battlefield environments and subsequently train and equip our soldiers to operate in the same. We will aggressively implement our modernization program and fast-track the procurement of advanced weapon systems that provide cost-effective and precise target engagement, long-range and high-endurance unmanned systems, and modern air and naval platforms for strategic lift, interdiction, surveillance, and reconnaissance. Organizationally, emphasis will be given to current efforts to build a strong armed forces through the AAP transformation and defense reform programs. We will continue to refine and streamline our internal systems and processes to improve not only the efficiency and effectiveness of our services, but more importantly, the transparency and accountability of our transactions. Our human resources will be developed as we procure additional personnel to fill up new units to be organized. Leader development will be enhanced to better prepare emerging leaders to assume key positions in our organization and for them to effectively discharge their duties and responsibilities in a complex security environment. A review of existing military camps and installations will be undertaken to ensure that they conform to our basing strategy. The organization and capability of our reserve force to include active auxiliaries will be strengthened in order to improve their readiness to respond to the call to service. All of this we will pursue even as we continue to look after the welfare of our men, most especially our battle casualties. Men and women of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, there is no better time for us to finish our campaign than now. Our high approval and trust ratings show that we have the overwhelming support of our countrymen, and our Commander-in-Chief is providing us with the tools and resources that we need to prosecute our mission. It is now up to us to continue to fulfill our part. President Duterte, sir, allow me to reiterate my gratitude for this opportunity to serve as the AFP Chief of Staff. I also thank Secretary Delfin Lorenzana for his affirmation and endorsement, and General Eduardo Emanyo and the Board of Generals for recommending me to this position. To my loving wife, Jane, and my children, Gabby, Paolo, Rafi, and Nina, who have all endured my absences with grace and understanding, you are my inspiration and the anchors of my life. To the men and women of the AAP, I urge you all to adhere to the highest standards of excellence and professionalism as we continue to fulfill our mission and as we live up to our pledge. Day in and day out, as we go about our duties, remember always that the hopes and dreams of many of our countrymen depend on how well we perform our patrols, how relentless we are in the face of storm or quake or siege, and on how committed we are in the service of God, country, and people. To our partners and stakeholders, please continue to support our troops as they give their best to win the peace and win the future. To General Anyo, sir, thank you for your outstanding stewardship of the Armed Forces of the Philippines. The men and women of the AAP are grateful for your dedicated service. Fellow soldiers, ours is a duty unique and invaluable, and it is the Filipino people's faith in our commitment and our capability that will drive us to secure, rescue, and protect. I am confident that with your dedication and zeal, we will prove to be an instrument of peace and an enabler of progress. I know that your bravery and patriotism will continue to be the impetus in our quest to be the armed forces that our country can truly be proud of. Our way ahead is clear. Our targets are in sight. Let us move forward together with purpose. Mabuhay ang sandatang lakas ng Pilipinas. Mabuhay ang Pilipinas. Mabuhay po tayong lahat. Salamat po.
Thank you to the new Chief of Staff, Armed Forces of the Philippines.
That was Lieutenant General Leonardo Guerrero, the new AFP Chief of Staff, giving his remarks at the change of command ceremony being held there in Camp Aguinaldo. General Guerrero takes the helm from General Eduardo Año, who's reached the mandatory age of retirement. General Guerrero, though, will only hold the post for under 2 months, as he himself will reach the mandatory age of retirement before the year ends. The President appointed Guerrero October 25th. He is a member of PMA Class 1984. He was the commanding general of the Eastern Mindanao Command covering Davao City. According to an article on ABS-CBNnews.com, he's known to be a close friend of the president. In fact, he was rumored to be the president's original choice but had to appoint General Año due to the seniority rule. Guerrero began his military career March 11 in the year 1983. In his speech, General Guerrero pledged to serve the country with selfless dedication. He said he will use the AFP's might to neutralize threat groups. He also said that there is a need to continue reform, saying the organization must improve its capabilities. Guerrero promised transparency and accountability in the AFP under his watch. In the end, General Guerrero, the new AFP Chief of Staff, thanked the President for giving him this opportunity to lead the armed forces of the Philippines. He called on his fellow men in uniform adhere to the highest standards of excellence and professionalism. In closing, General Guerrero said that he is confident that the AFP can be an instrument of peace and an enabler of progress. Back to the rest of the news here in the newsroom. U.S. President Trump won't say if he'll visit the Korean Peninsula's demilitarized zone during his upcoming tour of Asia. Trump leaves the United States November 3rd for a trip that includes visits to Japan, China, Vietnam, South Korea, and the Philippines.
What?
The DMZ. Yes or no? Are you going? Yes or no?
Well, I'd rather not say, but you'll be surprised.
Tensions are high between the U.S. and North Korea. Trump has criticized North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, calling him Little Rocket Man. He also threatened to unleash fire and fury on Pyongyang if it does not abandon its nuclear ambition. Heading to Turkey now, where a court in Istanbul has ordered 8 human rights activists released from prison pending a verdict on their trial on terrorist charges. The defendants include Amnesty International's Turkey director. They were arrested while attending a digital security training workshop last July.
We are really grateful. For everybody who supported us legally, diplomatically, and with solidarity.
We have a big new family now. Thank you, everyone. Wherever you are, however you did it, you got us out. Thank you very much. I'm gonna cry in about 12 seconds, so I think I'm gonna stop right here.
The human rights activists were charged with plotting an uprising, aiding Kurdish and left-wing militants, and helping a U.S.-based cleric blamed for a 2016 coup attempt. They faced up to 15 years in prison if convicted on all charges. Here at home, thousands pay their last respects to Ricardo Cardinal Vidal, who was laid to rest in Cebu today. More from Caroline Howard.
A day of mourning in Cebu, as Cebu Archbishop Emeritus Ricardo Cardinal Vidal is laid to rest. On Thursday, thousands joined the funeral rites for the late Cardinal, who passed away on October 18th at the age of 86. In his message read during Thursday morning's Requiem Mass at the Cebu Metropolitan Cathedral, Pope Francis said he joins Filipinos in mourning the Cardinal's passing. The Pontiff also praised Cardinal Vidal for his advocacy of dialogue and peace.
Today, our sadness for the death of Cardinal Vidal is allayed by our firm faith in the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, as the good cardinal shared in the forsakenness of Jesus on the cross, he will surely take part in the new life that will never end. We accompany him with our prayers as we also entrust him to the maternal embrace of the Blessed Virgin Mary.
From the homily to the eulogy, friends in the clergy also paid tribute to a man for others who will be fondly remembered.
You sat at table while the warring parties tried to resolve their differences. Your Eminence, you simply listened in silence. But your presence allowed the parties to talk to each other in a civil and rational manner, not because they respected each other, but because they respected you. In their respect for you, they had to listen to each other. In listening to each other, they began to appreciate each other's point of view. It was not long before they came to an agreement and came out of the meeting as friends.
I'm sure that during these past days, we have heard many anecdotes, stories about the good cardinal. And I'm sure many of you would want to grab the microphone and share your story. If that happens, we will be able to bury him 2 years from today. So please continue telling your stories as a celebration of the completion of life of this good and great servant of the church.
All right, let's go back to Camp Aguinaldo now as outgoing AFP Chief of Staff General Eduardo Año is delivering his valedictory speech. Let's listen in.
Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, Vice President Maria Leonor Robredo, Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines, former President Fidel B. Ramos, and also a former Chief of Staff AFP, former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, Ma'am, and now Congresswoman of the 2nd District of Pampanga, Secretary Delphine N. Lorenzana, Secretary of National Defense, and Mrs. Edith Lorenzana, Lieutenant General Ray Leonardo B. Guerrero, the newly designated Chief of Staff, AAP, and Mrs. Jane Guerrero, and their children, Gabriel Antonio, Victor Paulo, Rafael Waldo, and Lubina Ray. My lovely wife, Jean, and our children, Edwin Jr. and Anna, Edward and Christine, Janelle Marie, Jasmine Claire, and our grandchildren, Xander and Carrie. My loving mother, Nanay Huling. Executive Secretary Salvador Meljaldea, sir. Members of the Diplomatic Corps, His Excellency Asad Alam Syam of Bangladesh, His Excellency Xiao Jianhua of China, His Excellency Ephraim Ben Matichiao of Israel, His Excellency Win Naing of Myanmar, His Excellency Luis Antonio Calvo Castaño of Spain, His Excellency Rubensio de Jesus Martins of Timor-Leste, His Excellency Sung E. Kim of USA, Secretary Wanda Corazon Teo, Secretary of Tourism, members of the House of Representatives, Congresswoman Elenita Milagros Ermita Buhain from Batangas, Congressman Rosano Rupino Biason from Muntinlupa City, Congressman Manuel Jose Dalipe from Zamboanga City, Congressman Jose Anthony Jonathan C. Alvarado from Bulacan, Congressman Mahmoud Mending Jr. from Amin Party List, Congressman Roy Loyola from Cavite, Congresswoman Bay Sandra Sema from Maguindanao, Mr. Peter Eric Pardo, representative of Congresswoman Rubiano from Pasay City. Families, relatives, and friends of the Anyo and Joso clan, please stand up. Thank you. Officials from Malacañang, Secretary Arthur Tabaquero, Presidential Advisor on Military Affairs, Secretary Salvador Panelo Jr., Chief Presidential Legal Counsel, Special Assistant to the President, Secretary Christopher Lawrence Go, Secretary Jimenez Esperon Jr., the National Security Advisor, Yusek Gloria Humamel Mercado, Cabinet Secretary, former Secretary of National Defense, Secretary Orlando Mercado, General Tan Sri Dato Sri Sulkipli Bin Kasim, the Chief of the Malaysian Army, and other Malaysian officials. Former Chiefs of Staff of the AFP, General Lisandro Abadia, General Benjamin Defensor Jr., Presidential Advisor on Anti-Terrorism, General Junicio Santiago, General Generoso Senga, General Alexander Llano, General Victor Ibrado, Yusek Emmanuel T. Bautista, Executive Director of the Cabinet Cluster on Security, Peace, and Justice, General Gregorio Katapang Jr., General Hernando D.C.A. Iriberi and wife Agnes, General Ricardo Bisaya, Police Director General Ronald De La Rosa, the Chief Philippine National Police, and other PNP officers, Lieutenant General Salvador Melchor Mison Jr., the Vice Chief of Staff Armed Forces of the Philippines, and his wife Cherry, Vice Admiral Narciso Bingson Jr., Deputy Chief of Staff AP, and Dr. Beth Bingson. Our Major Service Commanders, Vice Admiral Ronald Joseph Mercado, Flag Officers in Command Philippine Navy, and his wife Emily. Lieutenant General Rolando Joselito Bautista, the Commanding General of the Philippine Army, and his wife Shirley Ann. Lieutenant General Galileo Gerald Quintanar Jr., the Commanding General of the Philippine Air Force, and his wife, Dr. Marlene. Unified Commands and Commanders and JTF-NCR Commander, Lieutenant General and Mrs. Emmanuel Salamat, Commander Nolcom. Lieutenant General and Mrs. Carlito Galvez Jr., Commander West Mingcom. Lieutenant General and Mrs. Oscar Lactao, Commander Central Command. Major General and Mrs. Benjamin Madrigal Jr., Commander Solcom. And Brigadier General Jesus Panangkil, Commander JTF-NCR. May also recognize former Major Service Commanders, Lieutenant General Romeo Tolentino, Vice Admiral Ferdinand Goles, Vice Admiral Cesar Takad, Lieutenant General Jaime de los Santos, Lieutenant General Edgar Palurina and wife Erica, Lieutenant General Glorioso Miranda and wife Caroline. Members of the Joint Personnel and Special Staff and Commanders and Chiefs of AP-wide support and separate units and their ladies. Members of the PMA Matikas Class of 1983 and their ladies, please stand up. Thank you for coming. Members of the PMA Maharlika Class of 1984 and their ladies, please stand up. Brigadier General Tirso Dolina, Chief Chaplain Service, other generals, flag officer, and their ladies, our enlisted personnel, led by the AP Command Sergeant Major, First Chief Master Sergeant Romeo Handugan, and the civilian employees of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, Colonel Ernest Lee, Chief Jusmag Philippines, members of the Foreign Armed Forces Attaché, and their ladies, please stand up. Our friends from the AP Multi-Sector Governance Council, headed by Mr. Francisco Estrada, different AP financial institutions, Heroes Foundation, and Association of Generals and Flag Officers. My elementary and high school classmates, please stand up.
Ayun pala, the other side. Nasa kabila pala.
Other government officials present, AP officers, ladies club, our friends from the media, Team AP, ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant good afternoon to all of you. In Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1, and I quote, "For everything there is a season and a time for every purpose under heaven," unquote. Sa mga biyaya at pagkakataong ipinagkaloob sa akin, ako po ay lubos na nagpapasalamat sa ating pong may kapal at taus-pusong nagpupugay sa sandatang lakas ng Pilipinas para sa mahigit na 38 taon na makapaglingkod sa bayan at sa ating mga mamamayan bilang isang kawal Pilipino. It has been a singular honor and privilege to serve under the leadership of the President of the Republic of the Philippines and the Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, President Rodrigo Roa Duterte. Gratitude overflows as I say thank you once more for the trust and support you have given me as you challenge me to lead the gallant men and women of the AFP as the 48th Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, serving at the helm during one of the most defining moments of the AFP makes my journey more meaningful and memorable. Rising up to the challenge of fulfilling its mandate to defend and secure our land while sustaining its pursuit of genuine transformation imprinted in the AFP Transformation Roadmap has proven the AFP's strength and commitment. As testimony to all the men and women of the AFP have done together under my watch, may I respectfully submit a book entitled In Times of War, We Fight for Peace, which documents my tour of duty as the 48th Chief of Staff of the AFP. The recent turn of events in our defense and security landscape show how solid we are as Team AFP. Working seamlessly in joint operations, the past months have been filled with notable accomplishments that help in earning the trust and confidence of our stakeholders. Considering the tough and challenging task, I am proud to say that the Team AFP was able to rise above the challenges and fulfill its mandate as protectors of the people and the state. The recent Marawi campaign has proven our eternal resolve to secure peace and stability. The AFP, in its humble ways, contributed to the fight against global terror and helped maintain regional stability. Although we have bled, we have definitely delivered our strong message. Terrorism has no place in the Philippines. For your AFP will always be the vanguard at all costs. I have said this once, and I will say it repeatedly. In times that I visited our troops in Marawi to inspire them, it is them, our brave warriors, who have inspired me instead. As I talk to every soldier in the main battle area, I can definitely feel the highest levels of heroism, and I can see in their eyes an unequaled fighting spirit. We have heard countless accounts of brave soldiers being wounded and yet refusing to be evacuated and opting to continue fighting instead. Without proper rest, sleep, and food, our brave soldiers pressed on the fight, building after building, street after street. As I personally witnessed this remarkable attitude, I realize that indeed, victory is already on our side. It's just a matter of time. Now that the fighting is over, We give honor to the men and women of our AP, especially our fallen heroes who have offered the supreme sacrifice. Although their mortal bodies are no longer with us, their memories will forever linger, just like burning fire that will eternally give us inspiration to always uphold the Filipino soldiers' tradition of gallantry. Their greatest sacrifice and their heroism will never be forgotten. We often hear people say that there are two great days in the life of a person: the day we are born and the day we discover why. Humbly, in my case, every day I spent being a military man brought me to the discovery of the reason of my existence. Since the moment I took the oath to be part of the noble profession of arms, up until now, serving my last moment as the chief of staff, every single day has been a reminder of this borrowed life, of this rare opportunity, and the corresponding need to make it count, to live up to ideals bigger than myself. Because of the service, I had the opportunity to write the pages of my life hand in hand with well-meaning individuals, colleagues, friends, and even adversaries. Ang kwento ng aking serbisyo ay kwento ng mga kasama, mga kaibigan, mga katunggali, at mga mahal sa buhay, nang dahil sa inyo, malalim, malawak, at may saysay ang aking kasaysayan. If there is one thing I learned and would most likely like to emphasize to all our soldiers, officers, and enlisted personnel alike, it is this: no matter what your position or rank is, you are part of the team. Every player counts. The team either wins or loses with all of you working together or not at all. Positions and titles are temporary. People come and go, but that which we do together, our service at work, lingers far longer, for the ripples outlive us and ensure that the organization evolves, changes, transforms. I say this as well as a reminder to love your job, do your part, and make yourself a formidable, value-filled player of Team AFP. As my military career comes full circle, let me thank everyone who has greatly contributed to the success of the AFP during my stint. Foremost to the Lord Almighty for His perpetual guidance throughout my military career, and for the good health and wisdom that has always shaped my commitment of service, I offer every ounce of glory in His holy name. To the Filipino people, for the trust and confidence you accord your AAP. Ang inyo pong pagtitiwala sa amin, ang siyang nagbibigay lakas at inspirasyon upang magampanan namin ang aming tungkulin ng buong husay at katapatan. We are happy to be top as considered to support and participate in resolving other issues beyond our traditional mandate, because it is an affirmation that our service is valued and that our service is never forgotten. There is nothing more rewarding to a soldier than the validation and acknowledgement of the very people they are sworn to defend and protect with their lives. The outpour of support brings the morale of our fighting troops to the greatest heights, inspiring them to fight with all might and never minding the fatigue, the pain, the loneliness, and desolation that they have to endure. Maraming salamat sa inyong pagtitiwala at pagmamalasakit sa ating mga kasundaluhan. To our Commander-in-Chief of the AP, President Rodrigo Roa Duterte, sir, for the trust and confidence you have given to me during the most challenging chapters of the AP, your decisiveness and pure, clear guidance became the huge factor in attaining success. Naging matagumpay ang ating kampanya sa Marawi City sapagkat pinagkatiwala po ninyo ng buo sa sandatang lakas ang paglutas ng suliranin. Naramdaman din namin ang inyong tunay na pagmamahal sa ating mga kawal sapagkat nasaksihan ko ang inyong malasakit sa bawat pagdalaw natin sa ating mga sugatan at ng mayapang bayaning sundalo, isang tunay na karangalan ang makapaglingkod sa inyong pamamahala. To the Secretary of National Defense, Secretary Delpin Negrillo Lorenzana, for believing in my capacity towards your leadership and close supervision to the AP steered us towards the right path. As our martial law administrator, you have tirelessly supported and supervised the AP to be exemplars of being true public servants and protectors of the people. We are truly grateful to have an exemplary leader whose wisdom and concern became our steady source of strength. To the members of the IAP Multisectoral Governance Council, for your honest feedbacks and genuine sincerity, you have steadily been the conscience of AAP in all our steps towards attaining effective and enduring transformation. Thank you for providing us direction and being our moral compass as we tread the challenging road to become a world-class armed force that our countrymen will be proud of. To all institutions and individuals who have supported the AP during the height of Marawi campaign, for your endless show of support to our soldiers, your influx of moral, material, and financial assistance certainly boosted the morale of our fighting troops. Kayo po ang mga tunay na bayani ng ating mga bayani. To my mentors and former bosses, for your tutelage and guidance that instilled upon me the professionalism, dedication, and visionary leadership. I definitely learned well because you led me by example, and I hope that I also led well enough to pass on to the younger generations the valuable life lessons I have learned from you. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. To my MISTA classmates from the PMA Matikas class of 1983, your guidance and encouragement kept my own performance in check. All of you have been my steady source of inspiration and strength. I am forever thankful to all of you, mga MISTA. I admit that I may not have been the perfect leader, but I am certainly grateful to have the perfect team. From my partners in bringing peace to all parts of the country, the major service commanders, unified commanders, the commanders and chiefs of the AP-wide support and separate units, up to my close associates, the top ranks, the vice chief of staff, the deputy chief of staff, and the members of the joint personnel and special staff. To my OCS AAP family, thank you for your unparalleled support and their dedication. You have definitely made my job as the chief of staff easier, and I am also grateful to all of you. To all the officers, enlisted personnel, and civilian employees whom I had the privilege to be working with in all the units and offices I have been to, you are and will always be appreciated because all of you played an important part in everything I have accomplished. Our shared sacrifices will be one of my most cherished memories. To all our foot soldiers, airmen, sailors, and Marines, especially those not here today and are deployed in the front lines and the remotest detachments, thank you for continuously enduring the risk, deprivations, and loneliness of distant posts. I am and will always be proud to have led to the bravest and best soldiers in the world. And to our Marawi soldiers still out there, I'd like to recognize the presence here of Lieutenant General Galvez, Major General Pamonag, and Lieutenant General Bautista. Please stand up. They are our ground commanders that directly and personally led our troops in liberating Marawi. And if I am ever given the chance to go back in time, I shall gladly and willingly join you in battle once more, where the metal meets the meat, where I can share the risk and feel your struggles and see to it that you live in order to fight another day. And for those who have fallen through the night, rest assured that you are always remembered in thoughts and in prayers. Ako ay nagpupugay at tunay na humahanga sa bawat isa sa inyo, mga bayaning kawal Pilipino. And to the newly posted Chief of Staff of the AP, Lieutenant General Ray Leonardo Guerrero, with full trust and confidence, I pass on the saber of leadership to you. A seasoned and highly respected general with a vast experience and expertise, I know you are up to the challenge of leading our armed forces to more victories and accomplishments. I wish you the best of luck. You have the best men and women in uniform ready to serve under you. It has been my distinct pleasure to share my passion in service with you. Many years spent in this profession would not have been relevant if not for the imprints in history that we have attained together. Thank you, Team AFP. Palakpakan po natin ang Team AFP. Retirement is indeed a bittersweet moment. But on a brighter note, it means finally going home and spending more time with those who are closest to my heart. And so, I'd like to take this opportunity to express my gratitude to my family for being with me every step of the way and for towing the line as a family of a military man. To my very supportive wife, Jean, the love of my life, who has been by my side since I was a cadet at PMA, for having found a best friend in you and a loving mother to our children. Marrying you was the most important decision I have made in my entire life. Behind your grace and class is a strong heart who has endured the challenge of being both mother and father during the times I was away because of duty. Every honor and accolade I've received is shared with you, for you equally deserve all the recognition for everything that I have ever accomplished in my career. Let me also recognize my children and grandchildren, Edwin Jr., Anna and Sander, Edward, Tina and Carrie, Janelle Marie, and Jasmine Claire. Jasmine Claire is not here because she's studying in South Korean University. You are my strength and inspiration. All of what I've achieved would be meaningless without you. Your unconditional love, support, and understanding have carried me through. More than the honor of holding the highest military position, having a happy family is another thing that I'm so proud and grateful of. And as I hang my hat today, I am testament that the saying, a man may travel the world over in search of what he needs and returns home to find it. And now, as I end my remarks and render my final salute, allow me to once again to exhort the organization that has been my home for more than half of my life. I will be retiring from the military service, but certainly I shall always walk, talk, breathe, and live like a soldier. With the same passion and commitment, I will always be ready and willing to be of service to our country and people. Ikinararangal kong mapabilang sa hanay ng mga sundalong Pilipino. Salamat sa pagkakataong maglingkod at mamuno. Salamat sa mga kaibigang nakilala, sa karanasang natanggap at pagkilalang binigay. Lahat ng ito ay nagmula sa biyaya ng Panginoong Diyos. Lahat ng ito ay alay ng inyong abang lingkod sa sambayan ng Pilipino. Salamat at paalam. Hanggang sa ating muling patatakpo, ako ang inyong lingkod, Eduardo Manahan Anyo, Sundalong Pilipino. Mabuhay ang sandatahang lakas ng Pilipinas.
Thank you, General Anyo, sir.
Sampawan! Da!
The guest of honor will now be introduced by the Secretary of National Defense, Delphine N. Lorenzana.
Mga kababayan, mga panauhin at mga kaibigan, ang Pangulo ng Republika ng Pilipinas, President Rodrigo Roa Duterte.
Delphine, yung tag mo sa pagkabisita nandyan sa El Borro mo. Kindly, thank you for your courtesy and sit down. Troop Commander, could you please give the tikas pahinga to the troops?
Tikas! Pahinga! Tikas!
Vice President Maria Leonor Bredo, ma'am, magandang hapon po. Former President Fidel V. Ramos, alam mo, every time I get out from the vehicle, I'm always met by the Secretary of National Defense and the Chief of Staff. And he would stop me right there at the door of the car, and he'd bottom up my barong because I usually do not wear the last bottom. It suffocates me. And they would say, ibaba mo na lang yung fold mo sa barong. And it's not my fault. I got it from a former president, Fidel V. Ramos. He was the one who started the fashion, actually. Former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, Excellencies of the Diplomatic Corps, Executive Secretary Salvador Medjaldia, Defense Secretary Delphine Lorenzana, and the other members of the Cabinet, General Eduardo Anyo, I don't know if it's mentioned here, but General Anyo goes to be from a general to a secretary of the cabinet. He would head the Department of Interior and Local Government. But while he is prohibited from assuming the task for 1 year, and that is the law, from the military service to the civilian sector, you have to wait for 1 year. Either he takes the title of special assistant to the president or the undersecretary, whichever is tenable legally. And he will now supervise the Philippine National Police together with General Lito Coy. General Anyo, you're always welcome to report. Maybe tomorrow, I will wait for you. The new Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Ray Guerrero, and the Major Service Commanders, Police Director General Ronald De La Rosa, the members of the House of Representatives, the officers, enlisted personnel, and civilian employees of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, mga kasama ko sa gobyerno, mga mahal kong kababayan. I consider it an honor to be with you today as we congratulate General Eduardo Anyo for his successful tour of duty as Chief of Staff of the AFP. General Anyo's distinguished leadership resulted to a stronger AFP that did not just secure our nation, but also secured our people's trust and confidence in the military establishment and the soldiers that it represents. General Anyo took command of the AFP in December last year. He was immediately beset with natural disasters that tested his leadership skills, proving his capability outside combat. General Anyo effectively supervised the AFP's humanitarian assistance and disaster response operation during the Surigao earthquake and the typhoons Nina and Auring. As part of the AFP's duty of preserving and defending our territorial integrity, General Anyo also authorized the regular conduct of long-range maritime air and naval patrols in the West Philippine Sea and the Benham Rise, known popularly as ACA. It's now the Philippine Rise. The Philippine Rise belongs to the Republic of the Philippines, and it is our territory, and let it be announced today to the whole world that we are claiming it for our people and country. This was complemented by its active pursuit of a trilateral cooperative arrangement with Malaysia and Indonesia to address security concerns in our adjacent waters. Under its able leadership, AFP also faced more than 800 armed confrontations, resulting to the seizure of almost 2,000 weapons and the neutralization of more than 2,000 enemies of the state. May I just insert insert something. I will now request the Chief of Staff, General Guerrero, to supervise the destruction of all arms, whether high-powered or handguns. All of it will be destroyed in some place to show that we are also able to meet the challenges of terrorism and violence. Of course, the crowning jewel of his impressive career is none other than the Battle of the Liberation of Marami, which resulted to the neutralization of almost 1,000 ISIS-inspired insurgents, which include high-value targets being hunted around the world, or being hunted. As General Anyo leaves behind his legacy and marches towards his final review of troops, I am confident that the AFP will sustain its gains because of the organizational and capability upgrades initiated during his tenure. These upgrades include the acquisition of new air and sea assets, state-of-the-art communications, and the intelligence gathering equipment and the latest military hardware that were initially used in dealing with the now decimated insurgents groups in Marawi. As we begin rebuilding from the ruins of war, we welcome Lieutenant General Ray Leonardo Guerrero as the new Chief of Staff, with the hope that the AFP will remain at the forefront of our battle against all threats against our nation, external and internal. Let me assure you, the brave men and women of the AFP and other uniformed services of our government, that our government will do its best to enhance their capabilities and promoting the welfare of our soldiers and looking forward after the needs of their families. While this may not be enough to repay for their sacrifice, I am nonetheless hopeful that it would make them feel that our nation recognizes, especially in Mindanao. I therefore enjoin our troops to support the leadership of General Guerrero by remaining committed to your mission of ensuring safety and security for our nation. Armed with our people's unwavering trust and confidence, and fueled by the highest degree of professionalism and competence. Our soldiers and will always be the front liners in the building a strong Philippine country that is prosperous and hopeful. This is the bastion of lasting peace and prosperity. Congratulations, John Anyo and General Guerrero, at mabuhay kayong lahat. Sandali lang. I am not begging the issue. I would just like to inform the small man down there na beginning January, look at your paychecks. It would have doubled your salary. Hindi ko lang po talagang increase into a double number na in parity with your old base pay, because that would be somewhat like a creation of a new position. Ay bawal po yan, so you have to slide a few percentage. But just the same, you are the first in government to receive almost double your salaries now. And that is in recognition, especially to the comrades and to the Filipino soldiers and policemen who died in the line of duty. I will see to it that the wounded soldiers will be attended to, and for those who are into forced retirement, that we will have a program with them to make their lives happier in the next phase of their service to their country. Again, I say a little prayer every night. Yung mga sundalo kong namatay at sundalo kong pulis. And every night, I always hold the briefer. Ano, nakita ko yung resulta ng mga violent confrontations. I will not try to impose a lie on you. I do not cry, but I'm always on the verge of tears. Iniisip ko kanong kahirap niya. And that is why I went back and to and fro from our nation's capital, Manila. Pumunta ako doon sa Marawi almost seven times. Just to be with you and to show my solidarity na mahal ko ang aking armed forces, pati ang aking police. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much to President Rodrigo Roa Duterte.
Sampana!
President Duterte at the change of command at the helm of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, where Lieutenant General Rey Leonardo Guerrero takes over from General Eduardo Anyo. Mr. Duterte praised Anyo's leadership, which he said resulted in a stronger AFP by securing the people's trust and confidence on the military and the soldiers he represents. Mr. Duterte highlighted Anyo's achievements, most especially the recent liberation of Marawi. The president also announced that Anyo will be the next DILG secretary after sitting out 1 year. This is because the law does not allow a retired military or police official to get that position within a year after leaving his former post. For the meantime, Mr. Duterte says Anyo will be a special assistant to the president, supervising the PNP in coordination with the DILG acting secretary, Undersecretary Catalino Cui. The president also announced that beginning January, the troops' pay would have been almost doubled. They will be the first in government to receive that raise in recognition of their efforts. He also assured wounded soldiers and policemen of government assistance. Stay tuned for ANC Alerts. That's coming up next.
Strong hair is ready for anything life throws at it. Use Dove Men Plus Care Strengthening Shampoo with caffeine that makes your hair up to 5 times stronger, plus less hair fall. Dove Men Plus Care.
Still have damaged and flat hair? Get bouncier hair with Dove Oxygen and Nourishment. With OxyFusion technology, get the nourishment you need and the bounce you love. Dove Oxygen and Nourishment. New Dove Ultimate White is now better than ever. It's the first Dia with both vitamin B3 and 1/4 moisturizing cream. Proven to lighten stubborn dark spots from within. For ultimately beautiful underarms, new Dove Ultimate White.
Strong hair is ready for anything life throws at it. Use Dove Men Plus Care Strengthening Shampoo with caffeine that makes your hair up to 5 times stronger, plus less hair fall. Dove Men Plus Care.
Still have damaged and flat hair? Get bouncier hair with Dove Oxygen and Nourishment. With OxyFusion technology, get the nourishment you need and the bounce you love. Dove Oxygen and Nourishment.
I'm going to be a big-time banker! I'm gonna be a successful banker,
helping the biggest number of people,
making the biggest treats,
and winning the biggest race of all.
Are we ready to work, Mr. and Miss?
Your kids have big dreams. Help them to dream bigger here.
Ready, Miss?
Ready!
Kidzania Manila turns terrific too. Dream bigger!
Strong hair is ready for anything life throws at it. Use Dove Men Plus Care Strengthening Shampoo with caffeine that makes your hair up to 5 times stronger, plus less hair fall. Dove Men Plus Care.
This week on The Boss, celebrating 35 years in the Philippines retailing business, we speak with second-generation boss Frank Gaisano, who runs the largest retailer in the Visayas under the Metro Retail Stores Group, Inc.
We're still getting ready at this point. We're not there yet. You can always be in e-commerce immediately in day one, but we would like to do it profitably.
The Boss, Thursday, 7:30 p.m., only here on ANC, the ABS-CBN News Channel.
How can Mindanao's children finally run across school grounds instead of running away from gunfire?
We will have a conversation about a people's dream. We will talk about peace. We will talk about our nation.
There is really a problem of historical injustice, marginalization, human rights violations, and legitimate grievances.
If we pass the proposed Bangsa Morovisit Law, it addresses all these issues that we have identified since we started to talk with government.
Marawi now is bringing both Christian and Muslims together to work for peace in Mindanao.
This is ANC Presents Bangsamoro and Beyond, a national conversation.
Together, we take the lead. This is ANC, your news channel, your partner.
Good afternoon, I'm Ron Cruz. We'll give you the hottest news here and abroad and keep you updated on what's trending online. We'll also give you online feedback on news and issues so you can be part of the conversation. This is ANC Alerts. Companies are shifting to social media to promote their products. Why? As Michelle Ong tells us, it's more effective and a lot cheaper.
Views, clicks, and shares. There's a lot of money going around in the new age of advertising, digital marketing. This should not come as a surprise. The fact that an average Filipino spends 3 hours, 36 minutes online on their mobile phones, and over 4 hours on social media using any device, versus just the average of 2 hours, 30 minutes spent watching TV. GetCraft Philippines says brands are expected to raise their allocation for digital marketing to 35 to 40% of total marketing budget from the current 20%. And not only traditional publishers will benefit, even so-called influencers are expected to cash in. These influencers actually expect to at least double their revenue next year.
Raising awareness about your brand, you know, you may wish to work with big celebrity influencers or more established publishers because they really have the big audience. Looking at, you know, engagement and conversions, you may want to explore working with micro-influencers who love speaking and engaging with their audience, with their followers, or also the more niche websites.
These so-called influencers make anywhere from 5,000 pesos to 250,000 pesos per post. That's right, per post. It may sound big, but in fact, this is a cheaper option for brands, as the cost per view for influencers come down to just, on average, 3 pesos 60 centavos per post, meaning these brands pay just 360 every time a post is viewed, versus cost per view for the more traditional online publishers, which is at 15 to 20 pesos per view.
It is cheaper versus the more traditional and mainstream channels, and it's definitely an effective channel, which is why a lot of marketers are experimenting influencers and working with publishers in creating conversations and stories about their brands.
The digital shift is also changing the Filipinos' shopping habits, with more and more transacting online for convenience.
We have a main warehouse, and at the same time, we have a lot of merchants around the country. When you make an order, you just pick up the item and deliver it to you, which gives us a lower cost base and reflects as discounts to the customer.
This digital shift has certainly opened up new opportunities for money to be spent, to be saved, and to be made. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.
Twitter commits to stricter guidelines for political ads. The move comes amid increasing pressure from U.S. lawmakers to regulate advertisements on social platforms in an effort dubbed as Honest Ads Act. U.S. lawmakers argue there is a lack of disclosure for political spending on social media. In a blog post, the company said political ads will now be labeled with a purple dot and a text saying promoted by. Twitter says this will improve the social network's transparency in all kinds of advertisements. Users can also report inappropriate ads or give negative feedback. Meanwhile, officials from Twitter, along with tech giants Facebook and Google, are set to attend a hearing at the U.S. Congress on November 1st as a probe into the alleged Russian interference in the 2016 U.S. presidential elections continue. Classified government documents on the assassination of former U.S. President John F. Kennedy will be made public. With the hashtag JFK Files, U.S. President Donald Trump made the announcement on Twitter, saying the long-anticipated release will take place Thursday. Trump earlier said he does not plan to block the release of the files ahead of the National Archives' Thursday deadline to make them public. Congress passed a law in 1992 mandating the release of the files within 25 years, but the president has the power to stop it in the interest of national security. Trump's advisors have reportedly urged him to block at least some of the files. Historians believe the documents will not reveal any new bombshell or contradict the conclusion that Lee Harvey Oswald was responsible for killing Kennedy. President Duterte appoints GSIS Chairman Francisco Duque as the new health secretary. He will replace former Secretary Paulino Bial, who was rejected by the Commission on Appointments. Duque, not new to the health agency, he was DOH chief during the regime of former President Gloria Arroyo. During his term, Duque moved for the historic passage of two major legislations, the Universally Accessible Affordable Quality Medicine Act of 2008, and the Food and Drug Administration Law of 2009. Lieutenant General Rey Leonardo Guerrero is the 49th Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces. Guerrero replaces General Eduardo Año, who reached the mandatory retirement age of 56 today. Guerrero is the commander.